the red door.
Mm-hmm. Is it a modern door or an antique door? Tell me more about this door.
It's not square.
Mm-hmm.
It goes, it's like a top hat.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything else on this door?
No.
So when you're ready, open the door and let's see what's behind it.
Okay, I'm ready.
Mm-hmm. Open the door and walk through and tell me what you see. What's it feel like on the other side of that door?
Lost?
You feel lost?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about that.
I don't know where I'm at.
Mm-hmm. That's okay. What does it feel like in there?
I feel like lost.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what you feel. Tell me what you're seeing.
I don't know what I see.
Mm-hmm.
I just feel emotional.
You feel a shadow?
I feel like it's black. Mm-hmm. I can't see anything.
Okay, that's fine. I'm right here with you. I'm right here with you. It can't hurt you. What are you getting from that shadow?
Scared.
Mm-hmm. Okay. How big is this shadow?
It's like the whole room. It's black. I can't see.
Mm-hmm. It's black in there? Mm-hmm. Okay. You're totally safe. I'm gonna put my hand on your head, and when I do that, you'll feel totally safe. Totally safe. You'll be able to see the shadow and see it for what it really is. Totally safe. Totally safe. Now you'll be able to see what that shadow really is. And when I take my hand off, you'll be able to see what it really is.
It's a man.
It's a man. Mm-hmm. What does he look like?
Yeah. Orange red hair.
He has orange red hair. Mm-hmm. What else about him?
He has a beard.
Mm-hmm.
A mustache and cross.
Mm-hmm. How's he dressed?
Like the 1800s.
Mm-hmm. What do you feel from this man?
I'm scared.
Mm-hmm. What are you getting from him? He's mean. Okay. All right. Now, don't allow him to attach to you. I want you to interpret what I say to him, okay? And you interpret back what he says. I don't want you to allow him to use your mind or your body, okay?
Okay.
So, I want you to ask him who he is.
Who are you?
Mm-hmm. And listen for the answers and tell me.
Bob.
Mm-hmm. Ask Bob, what is he doing there?
Watching me.
Mm-hmm. So ask Bob, why is he watching you?
So I don't leave the house.
So you don't leave the house. Okay. Which house is this, Bob?
Our house.
Mm-hmm. Ask Bob who sent him.
No one.
No one. Mm-hmm. Ask him what he's doing in that house. He's your husband. Ask him why he's not allowing you to leave the house.
Jealousy.
Jealousy. Tell me more.
I see myself. On the floor.
What do you look like?
White, brown, light hair. In a bun. Loose bun. In a white dress. To my neck. I'm scared.
So tell me what's going on there.
He's in front of me. I'm on the floor. The floor is wood. It's old. It's a metal bed.
It's a metal bed.
And I'm clenched onto the, it's like a pole of the bed.
You're holding on to it.
And I'm on the floor with my legs to the side.
And what happened?
Hit me. I'm crying on the floor.
Tell me what he's saying.
I'm his. It's my fault.
What's your fault?
Everything.
What do you tell him back?
Don't hit me.
What's he doing?
Just laugh.
Now you can actually look at this as an observer. I want you to detach yourself from that woman's body and just watch it as an observer. You don't have to feel the feelings.
I want to.
Okay. So tell me more about this.
I feel trapped. I want to go downstairs.
I'm here with you. Take me with you.
I'm going down the stairs. It's a long stairway.
And where's Bob?
In the room. It's like the stairs, I can see the front door. It's an old, like, farmhouse. I see the door and I want to go outside, but I can't.
What keeps you from going outside?
Afraid of him.
What has he told you that he'll do if you leave the house?
Hurt me.
Has he hurt you before?
Yes.
Tell me more.
I'm standing by the door, looking out the window. Seeing the grass and the trees.
How does that make you feel?
It's not. I can only see it from inside.
Do you ever get to go out?
Sometimes.
What does Bob do?
He wears a suit.
Where does he work?
Court.
What does he do in the court?
He punishes people.
Is he punishing you?
Yes.
What is he punishing you for?
For not loving him.
For not loving him. right. Anything else there? What do they call you?
Jesse.
So Jesse, we're going to leave that scene and we're going to go back in time. We're going to go back in time when you were younger, when you met Bob. Let's go drifting and floating into the past. When you met Bob, where are you?
It's like a park.
Mm-hmm. It's a park.
And I'm walking in the park with an umbrella.
You have an umbrella?
And I'm wearing a hat.
Mm-hmm.
With a long dress with black lace-up boots, like inked to my ankle.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm happy.
You're happy. How old are you, Jesse?
17.
Mm-hmm. What happens next?
I'm laughing. I'm not with Bob.
Mm-hmm. Who are you with?
Jake.
You're with Jake. Mm-hmm. Who is Jake?
My boyfriend.
Mm-hmm. What does he look like?
Tall. He's handsome.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about Jake?
I love him.
Oh, you love him. Mm-hmm.
He makes me happy. I'm laughing with him.
Mm-hmm.
I love his hair.
What's his hair look like?
It's brown.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes to the side, but it has a curl.
Mm-hmm.
And I make fun of his curl.
So tell me what happens with Jake.
Bob sees us.
Mm-hmm. Who is Bob?
I don't know him then.
Mm-hmm.
He comes to us. Jake knows him.
How does he know him?
I don't know.
Is Bob older?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How much older is he?
He's 30.
How old is Jake?
20.
Mm-hmm. So what happens now?
He introduces me to him.
Mm-hmm.
And I smile. And I see my big smile wearing red lipstick.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a little flirty.
Mm-hmm.
Don't mean to be, that's just the way I am. And Bob likes that. We leave, we say our goodbyes, and we walk away. But I turn around. As Bob is walking away, he turns around and I smile at him.
What are you feeling or thinking about when you do that?
Flirtatious.
Mm-hmm. Do you like Bob?
No.
You're just being cute?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What happens next? Move on to the next significant event of that life.
We're at my house.
Mm-hmm.
Big patio.
Mm-hmm.
The kind that goes all around. It's white.
Where do you live?
It's in a town.
Mm-hmm.
But our house is big. We have money. I could tell by the furniture outside.
Mm-hmm.
My mom calls me to come outside. We have a visit. I think it's Jake.
Mm-hmm.
And I run down the steps happy.
Mm-hmm.
My hair's down. And I see it bouncing on the steps because I'm giddy. Because Jake is here to see me.
How does that make you feel?
Happy and sad because it's not Jake.
It's not Jake. You thought it was going to be Jake?
Yeah.
Who is it?
Bob.
Mm-hmm.
My mom has been waiting for me at the steps. She was stern.
Mm-hmm.
She just gives me a look. Like telling me to smile, say something to him.
Mm-hmm. And who is Bob that is so important?
The judge.
He's a judge. Mm-hmm.
Mama says he's here to ask for my aunt. I have to marry him. And I don't want to. I love Jake.
Why does your mama want you to marry Bob?
Because he's important.
Mm-hmm. Is that important to your family?
Yes.
To marry somebody important?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But he's ugly. And he has a belly.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like the way he's looking at me.
How's he looking at you?
Like he would like to rip my clothes off. He likes me.
What happens next, Jesse?
I'm in my wedding dress.
Mm-hmm. Where are you?
Oh, it's like, I don't know. It's the wall, it's wood, the walls are dark wood. Maybe a no church?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm in the room. I just have my dress on.
Are you alone or with others?
Mama's there.
How are you feeling?
Sad. Mama says, smile, I'll be okay. I told her no. I don't want to marry him.
What does she say to you?
You have to, girl. You have to. It's too late. You have to. I see my sisters. Behind Mama. And they're sad. They're sad for me.
They know how you feel?
Yes. Bonnie knows how I feel.
Mm-hmm.
But you can't say that. She's thankful. They're thankful. My sisters.
What are they thankful about?
That I'm doing this for them.
Mm-hmm. Why do you say you're doing it for them?
I'm protecting them, but I don't know for what.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see Papa. Where's Papa?
What happened to your papa?
He's dead. Wait. Mm-hmm. He was handsome. I see him laying in bed. He's ill. And he's pale. But he's still handsome. Mm-hmm.
Is this why you're having to marry Bob? Because your papa's dead?
Yes. Mm-hmm. He always told me, follow your heart, Jesse. Heart.
Do you feel like you betrayed your father?
Yes. Mm-hmm. He wouldn't allow this.
So what happens next,
Jessica? I say my goodbyes.
Where are you?
Outside.
Mm-hmm. Who are you with?
Mom is aside, beside me. Bob's on the other side. The car's ready. Mm-hmm. And I hate my mama. I look at her and I feel hate. She tells me to hug her and I don't want to hug her. She has no... no feelings. She's not showing emotion. She's not sad for me. She just grabs me by the arms and just brings me toward her and just gives me just a kiss and whispers in my ear, you do what you have to do, but you make him happy. Bob is waiting with the door open. It's an old car. Like, I don't know, like, I don't know if it's a car away or a buggy.
Take a look at it.
It's like a car. It's really fancy. Mm-hmm. But it's an old time car.
Mm-hmm. How do you turn it on?
You turn it.
Mm-hmm. You crank it up.
Mm-hmm. And there's beautiful white flowers on it. I don't want to get in. Because I know once I get in, it's over.
What happens next, Jesse?
We're at home.
Whose home is this?
His home. Mm-hmm.
What's it look like?
It's like a big farm.
Mm-hmm. A big farm.
Not as pretty as mine. Mm-hmm.
Does anybody else live there with you?
We have a girl. Mm-hmm.
What does she do there?
She helps me. Mm-hmm. She talks to me.
How old is she?
She's like my age.
Mm-hmm. How old are you?
18. Mm-hmm.
So what happens when you get to your home?
He tells me this is your home now. He's nice right now. Mm-hmm. He tells me he won't push me. that you'll be patient. That comforts me. Mm-hmm. But I feel scared still. Mm-hmm. If he takes us to the room, I go up the steps slowly. I don't want to go. I don't like my room. It's cold.
Is this your room or do you share it with him?
We share it. Mm-hmm.
Why do you say it's cold?
It feels cold, empty. Mm-hmm. Just simple. I'm used to having flowers. I'm a southern girl. I like southern flowers. Pink. This is too boring. I don't have my vanity.
What else happens there?
I don't know.
Let's move on to the next significant event that happens okay. in your life.
Me and the girl are cooking. She's black. And she showed me how to cook.
How does that feel?
Good. I like her. She's nice. She's my friend. Mm-hmm. I just don't can't think of her name. But I can see her. Mm-hmm. She always calls me Mrs. and I tell her to stop. My name is Jessie. She don't have to call me Mrs. I don't like that.
What does she say?
She knows I'm sad. And she helps me. Mm-hmm. So she gives Jake a letter for me.
What did you say in the letter to Jake?
That I love him. That I will always love him.
How does he find out?
He followed name. I can't think of her name.
So what happens next, Jesse?
I don't know that he knows it. She went to go get water. I'm wearing a blue dress. I remember I'm barefoot. My hair's down, but it's curled. Long curls. There's a door to the kitchen. He comes in through there. And he's mad. I'm by the sea. I still don't know that he knows. He comes to me. I'm not expecting it, and he swings at me. I vomit to the ground, but I hold on to the sink. There's blood. And I'm crying. I know he knows, but I don't say anything. He said he... You made this decision, now you obey. You obey.
What does he mean by that?
I don't know. Wait.
What happens next, Jesse?
Never do it again. He says it's too late. I have to get punished because that's what he does. So he rapes me. And the only thing I can think of is, please don't get pregnant. Please don't get pregnant. Sitting on the bed, buttoning up his shirt, and says, "What's for supper?" I wish I could kill him, but I don't have the heart to do it.
So Jesse, let's close that scene behind you. Close that scene and let's move ahead to another significant day in that lifetime. What's happening?
I'm on the rocking chair.
You're on the rocking chair.
Mm-hmm. I'm knitting.
Mm-hmm. How old are you there?
Maybe 22?
Mm-hmm. Are you inside or outside?
Inside.
Mm-hmm.
By the fire. And he's mad. because I'm an idiot. And he says, what am I needy for? If I can't even give him kids. You're useless, he tells me.
How does that make you feel, Jesse?
Sad. Because I don't want no children. But it makes me sad to think that I can't give him children. Mm. Or that I can't have children.
What happens next?
He goes to bed. And I left alone there.
Mm-hmm. What thoughts are going through your mind?
Where's Jake?
Mm-hmm. You feel like you want to be rescued by him?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But he doesn't come.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where he's at. This is my life now.
So let's close that scene now. Let's move ahead to another important time when something significant has happened.
Mama comes. She's smiling and happy to see me.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
She's being fake.
She's being fake?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
She doesn't love me.
How do you know that?
She would do this to me. If she did. Mom told me to make sure I act happy though. I'm trying. I really am.
Is it working?
No. And I know I'm gonna get in trouble.
How do you act?
Like I'm in another world. My mind's not there with them. Mm-hmm. And they can sense it.
Where is your mind?
Outside.
Mm-hmm.
Thinking what if.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel like you've split yourself off from yourself?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just living day by day. I feel hollow inside.
Mm-hmm. How does it feel? Do you feel like you've lost a part of you, Jesse?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And where is the other part?
With Jake.
Mm-hmm. So what happens now with Mama's here?
We have supper. She stays a while. Oh, but she's leaving. And I know it's coming. But I don't care. I'm used to it.
Mm-hmm. What is it that you're used to, Jesse?
The beatings.
Mm-hmm.
Oh gosh, I'm getting nervous.
Tell me what's happening, Jesse. Why are you getting nervous?
Because Mama's driving off. And we're alone now.
Does he act differently when your Mama's gone?
Oh, yes, yes.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't do good. I didn't fake it good enough for Mama.
He's mad at you for that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what does he do?
Oh, tells me to go upstairs.
What does that mean?
Oh, I'm gonna get raped. and be
Jesse, what do you do to survive these rapes and beatings? What do you do in your mind?
I leave. I'm in the...
You leave your mind? Mm-hmm. Where do you go?
To when I was happy. Mm-hmm. To the picnic. Me and Jake would take picnics together. We'd be in the field with flowers, and he would be... bring a, like... so charming. Mm-hmm.
So this is where you think of where you go.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Does that help you?
Yes. Mm-hmm. But those memories are fading now. It's getting harder every time. I wish I would just die.
Mm-hmm. So let's leave that scene now. Let's move to another significant day in your lifetime there.
He's sick.
Mm-hmm. Bob is sick?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm happy. Because I know he's dying.
How old is he?
40.
Mm-hmm. What's wrong with him?
He's coughing. Coughing up blood.
And what are you doing?
Wiping his forehead.
Mm-hmm. Are you caring for him?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I think he deserves to die.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm ready for him to go.
You'll tell me what happens next.
We're at the grave.
We're at the grave? Mm-hmm. Who's there with you?
The girl.
Mm-hmm.
He tells me it's finally over, Mrs.
It's finally over, Mrs. Mm-hmm. How are you feeling?
Relieved, but tired.
Mm-hmm.
And sad. Not for Bob. For me.
Mm-hmm. Why? What happened?
I feel like my life is over. My life has gone by. My life was wasted.
How old are you?
I don't know, 35.
Mm-hmm.
My body's not the same anymore.
How has it changed?
It's weaker. From the beatings, my body looks old. I feel old and tired.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So let's close that scene and let's move ahead. Tell me where you are now.
I'm at home. Alone.
Mm-hmm.
I'm old.
How old are you there?
50.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't look the same. I look like Mama.
Mm-hmm. What do you do now?
Nothing. I'm waiting for the day.
Mm-hmm. Waiting to just pass?
Yes.
And finish?
Yes.
Right. So let's move ahead until we get to that day. The last day of your life. And tell me what you're... Where are you?
I'm in bed.
Mm-hmm. Are you alone or was somebody with you?
Just a girl. She never left my side.
Mm-hmm. How old are you there?
60 maybe, or...
Mm-hmm.
55.
What's wrong with you?
I just feel tired.
So what are your last thoughts as you're taking your last breath? What do you think about?
I lived a loveless life.
You lived a loveless life?
I'm dying unhappy, alone. And that's the last person I see in my mind.
Okay.
This Jake.
So now you've taken your last breath. You leave your body behind.
Yes.
Whatever has happened has already happened. You're on the other side of it now. And tell me what happens to your spirit as you leave your body.
It's floating up.
Where do you go?
To heaven.
Tell me what you're feeling or seeing.
Jake. He's there.
Jake is there waiting for you?
Yes.
He's passed also. So tell me what you say to each other.
I love you. But I'm young again. He's young. And he's still handsome.
He's still handsome? He still has the curl?
Yes. And he asks for forgiveness. He tells me to forgive him.
Why do you need to forgive him?
For not coming for me. He won't make it up to me. He'll make it up to me.
Ask him how he'll make it up to you.
He says I will love you again.
Good. So tell me what happens after that.
There's other people, but I don't see them. Their faces.
Let's find out who these people are.
There's an angel.
An angel?
There's another girl, but I don't know her.
Do they say anything to you?
They say you've suffered enough. Your suffering is over.
Ask them what were the lessons that you were supposed to learn in that lifetime?
Money is not important. To follow my heart. Position. What do people say is not important.
You lived that life always thinking about what people were saying to you?
Yes. Mama said, what would people say? What would people say, child? She'd say all the time. We're the Braxtons, she would say. We have to live up to that name.
And where did you live in that lifetime?
It was southern, I don't know. Georgia, maybe.
So now that you're on that side, you could look at that life from a different perspective. What lesson did you learn from that?
To fight for what you want.
You didn't do that, did you?
No. Not at all. And to think of me. Don't think about others.
Mm-hmm.
Think about my well-being.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now that you're on the other side of it, what would you like your next life to be like?
Would it be in love?
Mm-hmm. So Jesse, from that side, you have another aspect of you living in the life of Nubia. Take a look at her life and see if you see any comparisons. Mm-hmm. She's living the same life as you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to tell her?
To follow her heart.
Mm-hmm.
You know that he's the one. He's the one.
So to follow her heart. Mm-hmm. Now, Jesse, when you were in that lifetime, you lost a part of your soul, didn't you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Let's do something now and retrieve that part of your soul that's missing.
Okay.
Because if you lost it, Jesse is also missing that part of your soul. Okay. So I want you to follow the thread to wherever your soul is hiding, that part of you that split away from you when you were being raped. I want you to follow that thread and tell me where it is.
It's right here.
Mm-hmm. So go ahead and retrieve that part of your soul. Mm-hmm. And put it where it belongs. Mm-hmm. And how does that feel?
Good.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel completely whole now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything else that you're missing from your soul, from that lifetime? Mm-hmm. Take a look and see if there's anything else that's missing.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else that's split off in those beatings and rapes?
Our confidence.
The confidence.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't have confidence.
Mm-hmm. So where did that confidence go?
It's on her feet.
It's in her feet. So go ahead and pull that confidence out.
Okay.
And put it back where it is. Should be. Mm-hmm. How does that feel now?
Good.
Good. What else is missing from her that you lost?
Self-worth.
Mm-hmm. And where is that piece missing?
Here.
Mm-hmm. In your genitals?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So let's take that piece and put it back where it belongs. Mm-hmm. How does that feel?
Good.
What else did you lose? Love. Mm-hmm.
She doesn't have love right now.
Mm-hmm. Where did that love go?
It's just in the lost in the world.
Mm-hmm. So let's retrieve that love.
Okay.
Call it back. All of that love has consciousness. It's what makes her who she is that love. I want you to call that love back. Call it back. Where is it hiding?
In her memories.
In her memories. Mm-hmm. So bring all that love back. Call it back. Mm-hmm. What is it that you're using to bring it back?
Jake.
Mm-hmm.
Memories with Jake.
How does that feel?
Feels so good.
Mm-hmm. So fill her with all of that love now. All of those memories of Jack, of how much she loved him and he loved her. And that love belongs to her.
It's back.
Better. Mm-hmm. Is there anything else there? Because she had issues with her mom, with your mama.
She needs to forgive.
She needs to forgive.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
She did it for their well-being. She has to understand that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think she does.
Mm-hmm.
There's the what else? If it wasn't with her, it would have been the other girls.
It would have been the other girls.
Yes.
All right. So, Jesse, I'm going to put my hand on your chest, okay? And when I put my hand on your chest, I want you to give me all of those feelings that you felt during that lifetime that no longer resonate with you. You know that you are full love, fully full of love. Now, give me all of those things that you couldn't forgive before. Pull it all out of your soul. All of resentment, all of that fear against being against all those people that you felt turned their backs on you. Give me all of that. Pull it out of every bit of your essence. Tell me when it's done.
Let's go.
All right, we're going to take it and we're going to send it up to the universe for healing. Now, Jesse, in that space, what would you like to fill it with?
Love.
All right, we're going to fill that space with love and seal it in there. How does that feel?
Good.
Do you need anything else to feel complete and whole? Mm-hmm. Let's put a lot of security in there and seal it. How does that feel?
Good.
Mm-hmm. Now, Jesse, there's a lot of resentment that you felt against Bob. Mm-hmm. And you can't move on in your life without forgiving this man. Forgiveness does not mean that you agree with what he did. Forgiveness doesn't mean that you didn't suffer. What forgiveness means is that you will stop the pain. You will stop the hurting from thinking about this. Knowing that he didn't know any better as a human being. He felt that his job was to punish. And that you were just there. Can you forgive this man for not knowing how to love?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So give me all of that. Give me all of that and let's stop holding on to this pain any longer. Everything that you feel about Bob, pull it out of the entire essence. No more fear, no more hatred. Ready?
Yes.
Let's pull it out and send it into the universe. Now, how would you like to feel when you think about Bob now?
At peace.
All right. So let's put all that happiness in there. What else would you like to feel when you think of Bob?
Closure.
Closure. Let's put all that closure in. You don't need to feel that anymore. So now, Jesse, what I'd like you to do is I want you to look back at that life. And I want you to see it going backwards very quickly. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And as you go backwards, I want you to erase everything that is behind you. Okay? All right, so look at that life and see it backwards as a film. And go back to the time when you were with Jake, So go backwards and tell me when you're there.
We're there.
Alright. Now let's move forward very quickly again and see that the scenery has now changed. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And now you get to the end of your life. And now I want you to move backwards and erase even more. Go backwards very quickly. Keep erasing all of that. All of those feelings that you felt, all of those scenes. Keep erasing it and go back very quickly. And go back to where Jake was. Now go forward again. And what do you see now?
Me laughing.
Mm-hmm.
He's chasing me.
He's chasing you. And there's nothing else left of your life with Bob, is there?
No.
It's all gone now.
It's gone.
So let's just keep the memories that you have with him, with Jake. And that's the memories that you will carry on. And those are the memories that Nubia will feel when she's with a man. The feeling of love. Knowing that she is loved and she can love back.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, Jesse, for all of the help that you've given Nubia today. May the light of the universe accompany you. And you can go off with Jake, feeling at peace and in love. Thank you very much. Thank you. I know that you could have shown Nubia many different lifetimes. Why did you show her that one with Bob and Jake?
So she doesn't make the same mistake again.
Mm-hmm. Now we've gone back to that time and we've put some closure on there.
Yeah.
As your higher self, how do you see that worked for her?
Good.
Mm-hmm. Does she have to be thinking about her life in the same way now?
No.
Okay. May I ask the questions that she brought today?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. She wants to know what her purpose in life is. Why is she here?
Correct the mistake she made.
Mm-hmm. Is this with a life with Bob?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So how do you feel she's doing right now?
Not good.
Not good. Mm-hmm. Tell her what the reason is that she is not on the right path.
She shut love out.
Mm-hmm.
She worries about what people say.
Mm-hmm. Same as what she was taught with her mama.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What do you have to tell her about that?
That's not important.
Mm-hmm. So how can she correct that starting from today, now that she's seen how that life has affected her so much?
To follow her heart.
Mm-hmm.
She's been second guessing
mm-hmm.
a lot recently.
Yes, and what's causing that?
What people tell her.
Mm-hmm. Does she need to second guess herself anymore?
No.
Mm-hmm.
She knows.
Mm-hmm.
She's afraid to say it out loud. She knows she's found him.
Mm-hmm. So she needs to follow.
It's Jake.
It's Jake. And she knows it now. That's her true love.
Yes.
Good. She wanted to know if any of her relatives or her friends were her soulmates or part of her soul group. Who in her past lives did she know?
Bob.
Bob. Mm-hmm. Who is Bob in this life?
Miguel.
Mm-hmm. So in this life, she was able to give him the children that he wanted.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So he got his way.
Yes.
How does that make Nubia feel?
Angry.
Mm-hmm. Tell her why.
He doesn't deserve that.
Mm-hmm. But Miguel is out of the picture now.
But he still causes her pain.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to tell her about that so we can change that today? Jesse has already forgiven Bob.
She has to forgive Miguel.
Mm-hmm. Is she ready to do that now?
Oh, God, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard.
Mm-hmm.
She has so much hate toward him.
Mm-hmm. Well, it seems like they had a contract together.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. She didn't get it right in that life. And he followed her into this life.
She still didn't get it right.
And she still didn't get it right.
And that angers her.
Mm-hmm. So tell her what it is that she was supposed to get right.
Love.
Mm-hmm.
She went back and followed the same footsteps.
Mm-hmm. And he had to take the love from her.
Yes.
And that doesn't help her.
No. And mama's came back too.
Mm-hmm. Her mama came back? Is it the same mama?
No.
Who is her mama in this life? Her sister. Mm-hmm. Is it her older sister or younger sister?
Oh, her older sister.
Her older sister. Mm-hmm. So what is she supposed to be learning with her older sister?
To not listen to what people say.
Mm-hmm.
Because mama's the same. She tells me. She's supposed to tell her sister. Or don't. It doesn't matter what people say.
Mm-hmm. So what would you like to tell her about that? How should she handle that?
She needs to... Stop. Putting up a wall.
Stop putting up a wall?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And how? What should she tear down the wall with?
Love.
With love. Mm-hmm. Can you give her that feeling of love now? Have her feel it as a sensation in her body.
She felt it.
Wonderful. Do we need to continue to have these contracts with these people? In the way that she had in that lifetime.
Not if she follows her heart.
Okay. Can we break the contract with Miguel?
Yes, please.
Okay. So I'm going to ask Nubia to imagine Miguel in front of you. And I want you to tell him this. Repeat it after me. We tried. We really tried. But it's not working.
We tried. We really tried. But it's not working.
Let's break the contract.
Let's break the contract.
So I want you to visualize yourself with a contract that you made with him. And just rip it up and throw it away in whatever way you want.
It's gone.
Good. Now I want you to tell him, I forgive you.
I forgive you.
I let you go.
I let you go.
You go your way with love.
You go your way with love.
And I'll go my way.
And I'll go my way.
We don't need to be together anymore.
We don't need to be together anymore.
Mm-hmm. Now this does not mean that he will not be in your life. It just means that you don't need that contract anymore that you had of suffering. And now you can continue your life with love, knowing that you don't have to be connected. There's nothing for you to be connected with him except for your children. All right, let me speak with the higher self again.
Okay.
Take a look at her body and see if that worked.
It did.
Wonderful. She says that she also has difficult relationships with her kids, her siblings, her parents, and wants to know why she's having these issues.
She's afraid to get hurt, to feel love, have it taken away.
Yes. Well, now that she's seen where that comes from, does she need that anymore?
No.
So take that away from her.
Okay.
She had a question, which I'm sure that you can answer, is she wants to know if she will ever be happy in love without it always going bad.
Yes. She's found him.
Tell her why the other relationships were going bad all the time.
Because she wasn't listening. She didn't learn from her first mistake with Bob.
She seems to have attracted men that were just like Bob.
Yes.
Was she trying to find a different outcome? Or was she just attracting the same men over and over again?
Attracting. She wasn't strong enough to stand her ground.
So is she strong enough now?
Yes.
Wonderful. Why does she struggle so much with her finances? She was rich before.
Yes. She had it all. She never worried. Never had to take care of anything like that. And both with her mama and with Bob, he took care of everything.
So why is she choosing a life now with so much financial difficulty?
To see what the other side goes through.
To see what the other side goes through. Does she like what the other side goes through? So is she tired of this? Is she ready to go back to abundance? Okay. So tell her how she could get back to being abundant in her life again.
She needs to think positive and think that he will help her.
Think positive and that he will help her? Is she strong enough to stand on her own two feet with finances?
It's a little difficult. But Jake is gonna help her.
Jake will help her. Good. Good. Would you do a body scan on her to see how she's doing?
Sure.
Let me know when you're done.
Head.
Her head. What's going on with her head?
There's something there.
There's something there.
Yeah.
Where is it? Is that where it's sensitive?
Yeah.
Okay. Would you allow me to help her with that today?
Sure.
All right. So I'm going to take my hand and I'm going to bring that energy down, 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 down to express itself. Good evening.
Hey.
Who am I speaking with today?
Joseph.
Joseph. Good evening, Joseph. How long have you been there with Nubia?
A long time.
A long time. How long is that?
Years.
Years. Joseph, how old are you?
30.
30. And what year is it for you?
2001.
2001. Joseph, when you were alive, what were you doing? What kind of work did you do?
Outside work.
Outside work. And how did you lose your life?
Overdosed.
Overdose. What did you overdose on?
Crack.
Crack. Mm-hmm. So what happened to your spirit after you left your body?
It just lingered around.
Mm-hmm. And how did you find Nubia? How did you find her? What was she doing?
She was at the store.
Mm-hmm. What kind of store?
Gas station.
Uh-huh.
And what made... she was pretty.
She was pretty. Mm-hmm. Is that what attracted you to her?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Was it mutual in any way? Did she know you?
Oh my gosh, she knows me.
She does. Mm-hmm. How does she know you?
I just realized she knows me.
How does she know you?
I danced with her.
You did? When did you dance with her?
Long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
She was nice to me.
She was nice.
Yeah.
So is that why you came to find her?
Oh, yeah. But she knew me as somebody else.
How did she know you as?
Eli.
Eli. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That was your name?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I was Mexican.
Mm-hmm.
But I still had a drug problem.
You did?
Yeah.
And did she like you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So did she invite you into her life? In any way?
No, well...
Did she give you any permission to join her?
No.
No. So you just...
We talked. She was my friend.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to get to know her. But we didn't get to know each other long enough.
Mm-hmm.
I left and... I didn't see her for a while. I called her. Months, a year later.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know how we lost touch again. I know she would think about me every now and then.
Mm-hmm.
Wonder how I was doing. But she knew it didn't go nowhere because she knew I wasn't good for her.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't. She was good for me, but not me for her.
So what made her so vulnerable to you?
She has a good heart.
Mm-hmm.
She helps people. She would tell me to not do that stuff anymore.
Mm-hmm. So what was the purpose of attaching to her in this lifetime?
Try to realize that drugs are wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Because she don't do drugs. She's never done it.
Mm-hmm.
She's never had the peer pressure of doing it.
Mm-hmm. Have you given her any peer pressure to do them?
No, I don't want to do that to her.
Mm-hmm. So what do I call you, Eli or Joseph?
Eli. She likes Eli better.
Mm-hmm. So, Eli, how does it serve you to be in her head like that?
Oh, trying to make her understand what I feel.
Mm-hmm.
When I be happy.
Mm-hmm.
But she still doesn't get it.
Mm-hmm. What doesn't she get?
That it's hard. She doesn't understand how people... But I guess it's because she's never had people like that around her.
Mm-hmm.
She got lucky.
Yeah. What would you like to tell her?
That I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm. Eli, you ready to leave her now and go into the light where you should have gone before?
Are there going to be pain?
Do you think there'll be pain? What have they told you about the light?
It's a good place.
Mm-hmm. So why did you hesitate going there?
I wasn't ready.
Mm-hmm. Are you ready now?
Yeah, I don't want to hurt her anymore.
Mm-hmm. What have you been causing her all this time?
Pain, her head.
Mm-hmm. Are you the one who causes her the pain in the bridge of the nose?
Yeah.
What about the top of her head?
Yeah, it's me. I'm right there.
Mm-hmm. Anywhere else in the body that you're causing discomfort?
No.
Do you have anything to do with her weight gain?
Kind of.
What?
She was skinny when I met her.
Mm-hmm.
And she would starve herself. She would tell me, I'm hungry.
Mm-hmm.
She'd say, I didn't eat today, or I ate one thing, small portion in the morning. But she was skinny, she didn't need to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And she would tell me, I'm hungry, when we'd talk late nights. And I would, instead of telling her to eat, I would tell her, well, don't think about it.
Mm-hmm.
You'll be okay. Why would I say that to her? I'm stupid. She was so slim.
Mm-hmm. So what are you telling her now?
That is, starving herself is not right.
Mm-hmm.
She was fine.
So you're
and
the one
she wasn't happy when she was skinny neither.
Mm-hmm.
But she's not happy when she's overweight.
So have you been putting the thoughts in her mind to eat?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because you should have seen her. She was so skinny.
Mm-hmm. And she felt good like that?
She felt a little more confident.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't feel embarrassed to go places. But she still saw herself as fat. That's what bothered me.
Mm-hmm.
She saw herself as fat.
So what would you like to tell her about that before you leave?
That she wasn't fat. It's all in her head.
Tell her what she really is.
She's beautiful. That's why a lot of guys don't talk to her.
Mm-hmm. Tell her why, as a man,
she
why they don't.
She intimidates.
She intimidates men.
Yes.
Why is that?
Because she's strong.
Mm-hmm.
She's really strong. Not just physical strong, but she's been through so much. And she's so strong.
Mm-hmm. So she makes men afraid?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
She's actually stronger than them.
Mm-hmm.
They can't handle everything. They can't even handle what she's been through. They don't even know what she's been through. And if they did, they couldn't handle it.
Mm-hmm. So tell her something, Eli, to raise her self-esteem.
Beautiful. You have to believe that. That's why when I saw you there at the dance, I was attracted to you. A lot of guys are. You have to believe that. There's nothing wrong with you. It's not your fault. You chose the wrong man. I wanted you, but I wasn't right for you. And I understand that now. But there is one out there for you, and you know him already. So stop thinking negative. I gotta say, I kinda was jealous of him. But I see that he really loves you. He loves you, damn it, he loves you. Why do you always tell him stuff? Why do you always tell him negative stuff? Why do you always tell him it can't be? You're gonna lose a good man. Don't lose him. Don't worry about his age.
Thank you, Eli. Are you ready to go now?
Oh, gosh.
All right. Let me have Nubia say goodbye to you. Nubia, what would you like to tell Eli before he leaves?
I never forgot you. I always wanted to help you, but I just didn't know where to reach you.
Do you forgive him for all the pain that he's given you?
I forgive you.
Mm-hmm. All right, so say goodbye to him.
Bye.
Okay. Eli, I'm going to ask my angels of the light to come in and surround you now. And I want you to go ahead and leave by the top of her crown. And the angels will surround you and take you up into the light. And while you're doing that, I want you to pull all of the cords, all of the cables, anything that you have attached, pull them out by the roots, take them with you, pull everything out, pull it out, pull everything out, wherever you have any influence, take that with you. Take it up to the light for healing. And tell me when everything is out and you've reached the light.
Okay, yeah.
Wonderful. So now that you're in the light, I want you to beam down a beautiful, bright light and seal that area.
Adios.
Okay. May the light of the universe accompany you, Eli. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. Let me speak with the higher self again.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Has that taken care of those issues?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why is she having digestive issues?
Because she worries too much.
Mm-hmm. What can we do today to begin healing those issues?
Not worrying so much. Mm-hmm. Everything's going to be okay.
Okay. Good. Will she be able to accept that?
Oh, gosh, she's stubborn, too.
Mm-hmm. She's stubborn.
She needs to accept it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Good. Now, she tells me that every once in a while she feels a snake-like feeling in her gut. What is that?
Yeah, she has one.
She has a snake in there?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where is that coming from?
Just all the bad stuff.
Mm-hmm. Has she created the snake? Or did it come?
Well, she helped create it, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Are we ready to release the snake today? Do we need to talk to it? Can you pull it out? Or do we need to make peace with it?
I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know really why all it's there for.
All right. So would you allow me to connect with that snake?
Yeah.
All right. Let me put my hand over this area. And we're going to bring it up, bring it up, bring it up, bring it up. And express yourself. Good evening.
Hi.
Mm-hmm. Tell me, who are you?
Demon.
Oh. You're a demon. Mm-hmm. So who created you?
Bad people.
Bad people. Who are these bad people?
The haters.
The haters. Are these the haters, Nubia's haters?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Did they send you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And what do you do there for her?
Make her feel uncomfortable.
Make her feel uncomfortable. Do you make her eat a lot too?
And I'm full.
And bloated and full. Mm-hmm. And how does that make you feel?
Good.
Mm-hmm. What do you get?
That's my job.
What do you get out of it?
Satisfaction.
Satisfaction? Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
I'm black.
You're black? You're a black snake?
I'm not.
What are you?
More like a snake, like, but I got like thin, like,
mm-hmm.
Yellow eyes with black.
And yellow eyes, okay.
Mm-hmm. I sleep a lot.
You sleep a lot? And when is it that you move?
When I'm not doing my job, when she's feeling better.
Oh, I see. And who are the ones, is there anybody who in specifically sent you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who is that?
Her.
She sent you?
Not her.
Who's her?
A woman.
The woman? Mm-hmm. Is this a woman who's jealous of her?
Mad.
A man who's jealous?
A mad woman.
A mad woman. Does Nubia know of this woman?
Yeah, she knows her.
She knows her. Who is that?
I don't want to say.
Okay.
She knows her.
She knows her. Okay.
Hell, I'll tell you.
Okay. Who is it?
What do you want me to call? Bob? Miguel?
Okay. It's the same one.
It's his mom.
His mom?
Yeah.
Bob's mom?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Miguel's mom? Is it the same
sure
one?
Is.
Ah. So she was angry with her?
She hurt my son.
I see. Okay.
He left him. How dare her?
Mm-hmm.
How dare her not love him?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, Nubia is totally sovereign and has free will. And she can break any of the contracts. She can revoke any contract that's been created. This is her body and her life.
Mm-hmm.
And she doesn't need to have anything like this. So I'm going to call on the light to guide and direct this session right now. And I'm going to call on the warrior angels of the light to surround this area. Surround all of the area where this being is residing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to request that the mighty rescue spirits of the light surround this dark one with a mess of light, a net of light, a capsule of light.
I don't want to go.
It's impervious. It's inescapable. And I'm going to ask the mighty rescue angels to squeeze this capsule until that this demon is compliant. Now, Dark One, I want you to look inside of yourself.
Yeah.
Inside of you is your own key to freedom. It's your own spark of light. Everyone was created from the light. Look inside of you and see the spark of light, because we're going to help you today transform. You're already in this mesh, in this capsule of light. I want you to look inside now.
Okay.
And find this spark of light. Do you see it?
Yes.
All right. So now I'm going to call on Archangel Michael and the legions of heaven to work on rescuing you. All right, we're going to help transform you into light. Tell me what you're feeling.
I'm shrinking.
Mm-hmm. I'm asking. Tell me what's going on.
I'm out.
All right, I'm going to now ask the legions of heaven to gather every other dark one along with this one. Pull them all, any other ones that are waiting to take its place.
Come with me.
Mm-hmm.
It's better. Come on, guys.
I want you to pull all of the other demons that are waiting to take your place. Pull them with you. And I'm going to have the legions of heaven to work with you in transforming all of you into the light.
Okay.
Pull them all. Pull them all. Tell me what's happening.
Leaving her.
Mm-hmm.
Leaving her.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what's happening.
They're not gonna train her no more.
Mm-hmm.
They're gone.
They're gone. All right. So I'd like you now to encapsulate her entire body with that beautiful bubble of white light.
Okay.
Fill her with that white light. All right. Now I'm going to ask Archangel Raphael to help us here today, to help heal your entire body.
Okay.
And tell me what's happening.
She's fizzy.
Mm-hmm.
Tingly.
Tingly. Mm-hmm.
She can breathe better.
She can breathe better. Wonderful.
It'll get better.
Mm-hmm.
long time.
Mm-hmm. How is she looking now?
She's looking much better.
Good. Would you continue working with her at night when she sleeps?
Yes.
Keep healing her.
It's okay.
Is there anything else that you would like to do for her today? Any other message that you would like to give her today?
It'll be okay.
It'll be okay.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Is there any message that you would like to give any other family member or myself?
Don't judge her.
Mm-hmm.
Let her follow her heart.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Thank you very much for all the help and information you've been giving Nubia here today.
Thank you.
I know she's going to really appreciate it. Wide awake? Wide awake. Welcome back.
Thank you. Oh gosh, I cried a lot.
Yes. What do you remember?
Everything.
Everything. What do you think about that?
That explains a lot.
Explains a lot, huh? You lived through all that. Pretty intense, huh?
Yeah, that was really intense.
Mm-hmm.
Bob was really, yeah.
So now you understand where
Cassie.
Everything...
Cassie, her name was Cassie.
The girl?
The girl.
The girl was Cassie.
Her name was Cassie.
So now you could see that everything that you've been living this life is just a rerun of that one.
Right.
And you don't need to hold on to that anymore. Mm-mm. It's gone.
Wow. Oh, that was awesome.
How long do you think you were in this little journey?
About an hour.
You ready for the time?
Yeah.
2 hours and 15 minutes.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Incredible, right?
Just there.
You were there.
Just that lie.
Yeah. It's amazing. What about the part with the snake? How did that feel? That was intense.
Yeah. Good to know that I wasn't crazy. That's what it feels like to me when I would feel it.
Mm-hmm. And you know,
I've always thought that.
You know where it came from,
right?
Mm-hmm.
Which doesn't surprise me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So what we're going to do is we're going to make sure that all of the portals are closed.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And just make sure that you envision that bubble of light that we did.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. That's very important. That's your sealing light meditation.
Okay.
And before you go to sleep at night, you just bring that bubble around you, and when you wake up in the morning, you bring that bubble around you again, and that will protect you.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Because that's your protection.
Okay. And you know what Bob looked like?
What do you look like?
Do you know the movie, The Princess and the Frog?
Mm-hmm.
The man, that chubby man, mm-hmm. The way he was dressed, his hair? That's the first thing when I opened my eyes, like, that's what I can describe him. He looked like that. He had outfit like that.
Mm-hmm. He was a judge.
Yes.
He was a very well established judge,
yes.
And very nasty.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But now I look and I think about him and it makes me laugh.
Mm-hmm. Because you've erased that part of him. Mm-hmm. You've erased that part of your life. You don't need that life anymore.
Funny looking. No wonder I couldn't be attracted to him.
So, is this something that you recommend to other people?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And is this something that you would want to share with others?
Sure.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And we can take out any part that you feel uncomfortable with. Good?
Follow your heart.
Wonderful.
Yeah, wow. Oh, God, that feels so good.
What are you feeling in your body?
I feel like... Well, right now?
Yeah.
Like, just light.
Mm-hmm.
My feet feel kind of like a little tingly. I feel so happy. Why am I happy? I'm not used to this. Why am I supposed to be happy?
You told me you were never happy. How's it feel to be happy?
It feels different. It feels...
Feels good?
It feels good, but I'm like... Why am I laughing and smiling for no reason? Like, I feel like there's no reason to be that way.
This is your true essence. This is how you need to be. This is who you are. And you finally let go and allowed yourself to be you. Terrific.
Wow.
Oh, all right.
Okay, so here we are in Oklahoma City. We just had a really intense session. It was amazing. We did a lot of healing. And I invite you to do the same for yourself. It's a really beautiful experience. My name is Alba Weinman, and I have sessions in Miami, Florida, if you're interested in seeing more of my videos. They're on my YouTube channel under Alba Weinman. And if you'd like to make an appointment with me, you can go to albaweinman.com. Thank you for watching, and we'll see each other next time. Bye.